Dear students, yesterday we discussed about even mechanism, and today we are here with our new mechanism, that is even CB elimination mechanism, and this is called elimination unimolecular, that will involve the conjugate base. Basically, this is a two-step reaction, and this is basically a base induced reaction and a two-step reaction, in which first of all the base will abstract the hydrogen, that will abstract the proton from the substrate, and after abstraction of the proton it will give rise to the carbon ion. Generally the first step in this reaction is a reversible step, and that will form the carbon ion, and finally the carbon ion will be converted into the product by elimination of the leaving group. The leaving group will be departed and it will give rise to the product. So in this reaction we have an intermediate, and that intermediate is the carbon ion. So basically we are saying that this is the conjugate base, right? And that's why the mechanism is called as the even CB mechanism. And you can see the two step in the mechanism, that this base is particularly abstracting this acidic hydrogen and giving rise to carbon ion formation, and finally this carbon ion will form carbon-carbon multiple bond, and this X, which is a leaving group, will be eliminated out from here, and there is a formation of carbon-carbon multiple bond, that alkene has been synthesized. Now, when we talk about this reaction, the even CB reaction does not depend upon the nature of the leaving group, right? Even the hydroxyl group, that can also be removed in this case. So, we can say that this reaction is not that type of reaction which depend upon the nature of the leaving group. When we discuss in detail the mechanism of this reaction, we can find that three different parameters are there to judge the even CB reaction, and these three parameters are: the first one is the carbon ion returns to the starting material faster than the product formation. Means step one is a reversible step, and after formation of carbon ion there is more tendency that that carbon ion will be converted into the substrate, right, as comparison to formation of the product. So in this case, particularly in the first case, we are having the first step as the reversible step and the second step is the slow step, that is the rate determining step, and this type of reaction will be called as the even CBR. The second case, in case of elimination unimolecular conjugate base elimination reaction, the product formation is faster, means whatever the carbon ion has been synthesized during the course of reaction, that will fastly be converted into the product, right? And return of that carbon ion into the substrate is not very easy. Again, in this reaction, we can say that the step 2 is irreversible, that is not reversible at all, because the carbon ion that have been synthesized will get converted into the product finally, right? So that is particularly irreversible reaction. And when we talk about the first step, that first step in this reaction is slow, and this is even CB I. When we talk about our third parameter, that carbon ion goes slowly to product formation, means when the carbon ion has been synthesized, it will slowly be converted into the product, right? Because the carbon ion is quite stable in that case. Again, step one is fast and that is irreversible, right? And this kind of reaction, that is even CB mechanism, will be called as the E1 anion. In this case, the carbon ion that has been synthesized is stable carbon ion, and because of more stability of the carbon ion, the conversion of that carbon ion into the product formation will be slow, right? And that's why we can designate as E1 anion reaction. You can see some of the example on your screen that basically this is a case in which this hydrogen will be eliminated out by the base first, and then a carbon ion will be synthesized, and then carbon ion will finally help to remove this particular leaving group and be converted into alkene. Similarly, here you can see that this is the hydrogen that will be eliminated about this base and will get converted into C negative, and then it will be finally converted into the product. So you have studied these different reactions, and this is the another example of the E1 CV mechanism. And from all the three examples that you have seen on your screen, you can have one conclusion, and that conclusion is that you are forming the carbon ion. So the factors that will stabilize the carbon ion will enhance the rate of this kind of reaction. Means when the carbon ion that have been synthesized that is stable, for example we are having NO2 group attached to the carbon, at that time the carbon ion will be stabilized. We are having some more electron withdrawing groups which are attached with the carbon, at that time the carbon ion will be synthesized and that carbon ion will be stabilized. So for the reaction to be proceed with E1 CV mechanism, there is a possibility that the carbon ion that have been synthesized during the course of reaction, that must be a stabilized carbon ion, right? At that time reaction will be faster, right? For example, you can see it here, that here you are having CF3 group, electron withdrawing group is here, and again chlorine is also here, which is electron withdrawing. So the carbon ion which is being formed here will be a stabilized one, and that's why this reaction will be faster as comparison to formation of the another carbon ion. There are some more examples. I want to write it here, and you can depict it by having this one, that when we talk about the regioselectivity, the regioselectivity will be maintained in this case as well, right? For example, we are having this. This is your X. This is your leaving group. This is hydrogen. And this is carbonyl group. So you can see that this will be the hydrogen when it is allowed to react with base. At that time, base will attack on this hydrogen. Right? When base attack at this hydrogen, it will form this one. You can see it. Why this carbon ion has been synthesized? Because there is a carbonyl group attached in vicinity to this carbon ion. So this is stabilized. So it will help in departure of this particular group and will give rise to the product formation. So this will be the product that have been synthesized during the course of reaction. This one, right? Now I was talking about that regioselectivity will be there in this reaction as well. So with one more example, I want to show you the regioselectivity parameter of this reaction. We have, say, this is a case in which we are having X group and this is the hydrogen. So when this is allowed to react with base, at that time you will have these two kind of the products. One is this, and the another one will be this. That this is the E alkene, and this will be Z alkene. So regioselectivity will be there in case of E1-Cb reaction. There are some more examples that will tell you about E1-Cb reaction in detail. For example, you can see it on the screen that this is a particular substrate, and here you are having NO2 group, and here you are having OME group, right? So when this is allowed to react with sodium ethoxide, what will happen at that time? You can see the product formation in this reaction will be governed by E1-Cb mechanism. It will produce the product through this mechanism, E1-Cb. And what will be the product? The product will be you can see that this kind of product will be synthesized, right? So this is a case of E1-Cb reaction. So we have told you about the general aspects of the E1-Cb reaction, that this is basically a two-step reaction, and there are three parameters that will explain the E1-Cb mechanism, that it may be even anion, it may be even CBr, it may be even CBi or 1. Now, the second one is, you have already know that different mechanisms are there. Even mechanism is here, E2 mechanism is here, and even CB mechanism is here. And all the mechanisms, they are depending upon the substrate and other reaction condition, that which mechanism will be followed. So by watching the substrate, by having different type of the conditions, you can know that what will be the mechanism of this particular reaction. So we have here a particular theory, that is variable E2 transition state theory, that will explain about the different mechanism that can be followed during the course of elimination reaction. For example, you can see it here, that this is a substrate and this is another substrate. This is the order in which the carbon and the X is a leaving group. The carbon and X breaking, that will take place in the transition state. And this is the order in which the carbon and the hydrogen breaking in the transition state will be increased. Means from here to here, it will have the highest rate in which the hydrogen can be removed, that carbon-hydrogen bond can be broken down into the transition state. And if we talk about this substrate, it will have the maximum probability in which carbon and X, which is a leaving group, can be broken down, right? So when we talk about the mechanism that can be followed during the course of reaction, at that time it will naturally be following the even mechanism, because the CX bond will be broken down, and when X negative will be departed, at that time C positive will be synthesized. So this particular substrate will undergo even mechanism. When we talk about this particular substrate, it will also have even like mechanism. And when we have this kind of substrate, it may have E2 mechanism. And when we talk about this one, it will have even CB like mechanism, and this substrate will have even CB mechanism. So this is the variable that they have different type of arrangements. They have different energies of the transition state in which different kind of the groups can be eliminated out. See, there is another example on your screen that this is a case in which we are having E1 mechanism, and this is a case in which we are having even CB mechanism. And you know that this is a primary carbocation and this is a primary carbon ion. When we talk about these two, carbocation and carbon ion, both are unstable. So when energy profile diagram has been generated for this kind of reaction, you can see that this is a CH cleavage, and this is the CX cleavage, that is the leaving group. This is your substrate and this is your carbocation that have been generated, and from this carbocation this is the formation of the product. So this particular path is E1 path, and this particular path, this is basically again a two-step path. This is carbon hydrogen bond has been broken down and will get converted into the carbon ion, and then carbon ion will finally get converted to this one, and this is the path that is E2 reaction will follow, that it will base will attack on the hydrogen, and then simultaneous departure of this leaving group will take place. So when we talk about this one, and when we draw a diagram that will tell you about the energy of the transition state, that will tell you about the energy of complete reaction, at that time you can see that this is the energy concentration profile, that this is basically the even CB path, and this is the energy of the transition state that have been the intermediate that have been synthesized during this reaction, and this is the energy for E2 elimination, and this is the energy profile for the even reaction to happen, that carbocation has been synthesized, then it will again have formation of the alkene. So when we compare this one, we can see the lowest energy path is a concerted E2 path, which is almost diagonally across energy surface. And the reason for this one is there is a double bond character between these two carbons, and because of that one, this will particularly follow the E2 path instead of even CB or even path, simply, if we are concerned about. So by having different kind of condition, by having different kind of substrate, by having different kind of solvents, by having different kind of bases, that these are the different factors, these are the different parameters that will affect the rate of different type of reaction, that is even E2 and even CB reaction. And you can also depict the mechanism as well by thoroughly studying the different type of the condition. So this is basically a effect that you can have some knowledge about which path a reaction can follow. So that's all about today's lecture, and tomorrow we will discuss about various factors that will affect the rate of elimination reaction.